Hey, what's good everybody? It's your boy Crips here. We're back with another video. In today's video, we're going to be talking about the new stuff, the new event that is coming to Genshin Impact. So, if you guys didn't know, the Lunar New Year week is now upon us. So that means the new Lantern Rite is now out into Genshin Impact. So there's a lot to talk about, a lot of things to do, but today we're going to be talking about the Tower Defense. I don't think there's really much to talk about the other stuff. I guess I can really quickly go through them. So I guess all the glitters one is just another quest. It'll unlock in 3 days from now. Saying there's more quests here as well with the Lantern Rite Tales. And obviously the 4-star character select, you need to have a certain amount of Peace Talesmen, which is I think this. And if you get 1,000 of them, apparently, I guess you can choose whatever 4-star you want. For me, it's probably going to be Jing Q, most likely. I was going to think about Ningguan, but I think I'm going to go with Jing Q. So there's that, and then obviously the Zhao Market, the Tower Defense actually plays a part of this, so there's going to be a shop. Right now we're on stage 1, stage 2 actually has another crown, so that's going to be the 4th crown we can unlock, and obviously more materials and all stuff, and then stage 3 is actually pretty good. We got some talent books too, gold ones as well, so not too bad as well, so pretty cool that we get that as well into the shop. So today we're going to be talking about the Tower Defense, which is this section right here. I'm not really sure how these things work, these lanterns. I guess they're just kind of built up after you complete quests and all that sort. And then I'm kind of pretty confused with the Zhao lanterns as well. Maybe we'll make a separate video about that, but we're going to be talking about this. So the Tower Defense is actually pretty cool. I haven't really tried it. I've only done the trial, you know, trying to understand how it works. We're going to go through them together and then we'll see how it goes. So there's a bunch of like missions you can complete so you can get these materials. You know, like clear stage of difficulty 2 or higher with a score of at least 420 points. 420. But yeah, there's like a bunch of things you can do here. A lot of things to do. And then the second part, you know, these are locked at the moment. You'll unlock them after you do the quest that I kind of talked about during the, you know, the map-ish. So you're going to have to do some quests to unlock this. Right now, we'll just talk about this and then we'll just kind of go through the stages and all that sort. So there's different things you can do. There's like also like armory you can unlock, which they actually haven't unlocked. And then there's also like different stages here, obviously challenges to complete. So there's a lot of things to do. Also, I forgot to mention that to, you know, do a attempt, you need these lanterns right here. These Zhao lanterns, which you need to go to the crafting material. If I can maybe find a quick one here. Probably not one. Oh, yes, I can. Right there. So you're going to be crafting here. You're going to need these materials. I'll tell you where you'll get them. So the fiber you get from harvestable plants. So let's say like, for example, you know, violet grass. I think that's how you pronounce the one that Chi-Chi uses. They'll drop like these lantern fibers. And then these wick material will be dropped from Fatui elites or Helicurl type enemies. And then the shard will be dropped from harvestable ores. From Geovis shops and Stonehide Lawwatch curls. So yeah, so you're gonna need these to attempt the Tower Defense. Pretty easy to craft. They don't ask for too much, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, they just need one of each, and you can like farm a bunch of these, so very easy to get. So make sure you guys craft that to attempt the Tower Defense. So for you to like start the Tower Defense, you gotta talk to this Ruzhen first, the girl. But before you can even do that, you're going to have to do like a quest that is unlocked. You do a quest with Zhao. It's kind of long, a little bit long. Might take a few, like 10 or 15 minutes or so. You got to do that quest. And then also you got to do like some world quest too to unlock that quest. So it's very confusing. But all you got to do is do the quests that are in your quest page. And then you can unlock all this Lantern Rite stuff. So you got to talk to her. I'll play her around. And then there's also different difficulty multipliers. At the moment, I only have difficulty 1, so there's that. You can also do it with a friend, which is pretty cool too. So definitely a lot of options to do when you're playing this, and it's really fun too, especially if you're playing with your friends. So if you have some friends to play with, go ahead. Anyways, choosing your team is kind of really smart here. You gotta realize that in the Tower Defense, you actually do not take any damage. So you want to choose characters that can do elemental reaction, that can also stop the enemies as well. So Venti is very good for this. Zhao's not really good. So I think I'm going to probably run... I was thinking Sucrose, because Sucrose actually does kind of put them in the air and kind of like slow them down. So you guys gotta remember, like, levels don't count, right? Like, it doesn't really matter. And also, the characters you choose kind of does matter a little bit, because you can actually do elemental reactions into the enemies. You can't do damage, but you can do elemental reactions, which I will show you in a bit. So kind of strategically kind of choosing who you want to choose, I'm going to go with Diluc on this one. And then I'm also going to go with Sucrose. And then I'm also going to go with Ganyu here. Yeah, I kind of like this team. I don't know. Yeah, I was thinking about using Jean as well, because Jean can actually, you know, like, put enemies in the air. But then there's also going to be big guys too. So I think I'm going to run with this team. We'll see how this team does. And because I really haven't done too much. I've only done the trial. But I've gotten the gist of the tower defense. It shouldn't be too bad. So, if you guys ever played Bloons TD, I think that's what it's called. It's kind of similar to that. Like I said, you can't do any damage yourself, but you can slow down the enemies, and you can also do elemental reaction. The game will show you what path they go through. So you can see there's two paths they come from. So they come from that portal and that portal. You can, and then these little like circles things is where you construct the stuff. So, and then you've got to make sure they don't go into that blue portal, right? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a recovery MK here. So the recovery MK is very important, because this will give you more points, which you need to build. As you can see on my mouse, 350. I have 350 at the moment. So you need those points to construct things and, you know, add more, like, you know, items and all that sort. So it's kind of, you know, it's pretty strategic, right? You got to be strategic what you do, right? So for this one, I'm going to put Cryo Elemental there. And I'm going to put the Hydro one, because it does freezing effects, right? So there's that. So if you're ready to go, you can start it up. I'm going to put a Pyro one there. So it'll start up. You do have a limited time. If you are done, you can just start up the wave. So I'll try my best to explain this as best as possible. I'm not really an expert of myself, but I know sort of the basics. So they are pretty slow. I wish there was like a fast version for them to come, but yeah, they do come very slow. As you can see, you do damage to them with the towers that you built. You can also slow them down with your abilities. As you can see, I'm freezing them over there. You know what I'm saying? I want them to stay here, because then I can actually get more points. As you can see with the recovery MK, I get a lot more points if I defeat them in this area. This is probably one of my better strategies, you know, freezing them early. And then, like I said, you really want to take advantage of the elemental reactions, because then it does a lot more damage to them, right? So, there is that, right? So you just want to push them back, you know? I just want them to die in that area. They are kind of getting moved up a little bit, so there's that. Hopefully they die in that area. If not, oh. Okay, I might have to put a Electro one here. Because they do seem to be moving. So I just, you know, push them back. Like I said, I don't do any damage, but you can also slow them down with your characters and, you know, do elemental reactions. You actually don't get your ultimates in this. I probably shouldn't have brought Ganyu. I was hoping this flower would maybe like distract them, but I guess it doesn't actually affect them. So, I mean, I could do that, I guess. Yeah, it's not too bad, I guess. But you kind of get the gist of it. I don't think anyone escaped yet, so. There's that. And then you gotta make sure they don't escape. Like I said, you really want to place that recovery MK like pretty properly, so that you can, you know, you can at least get some more points, because you're gonna need more points later on. It will definitely get a lot harder. This is like the first wave, obviously, so it's gonna be a lot more easier. But you know, after you defeat them, you'll see that it will get a lot more harder. There's going to be faster enemies, bigger enemies, stronger enemies, you know what I'm saying? So you got to be really smart with everything. But yeah, I think Venti is like one of the best characters for this. I mean, Venti is an amazing character in itself. He's really, really good when it comes for this tower defense thing, especially in Nemo, because then you can do some swirl damage and you can kind of fuse in elemental reactions, obviously. Y'all know the drill with a Nemo. One of the best elements in the game. But yeah, you guys get the gist. As you can see, I completed it. Pretty simple, pretty cool. And then after you complete it, it'll give you some like cool other like things, you know, upgrades, I guess. So I'm not really a I'm not really. You can only choose one, I'm pretty sure. So you gotta remember. Well, I don't know. Later on, you can choose more. And they'll also show you the next wave. You got a few seconds and all that sort. So for me, in this next wave, one will appear along the pack. You know, I'm gonna do this one. No. I mean, it's free, and I guess I get more. I don't know what that does. I actually have no clue. So, yeah. Anyways, you guys kind of get the gist of how it works. It's not too crazy hard. I'm just going to do this off camera and all that sort and kind of try to complete it. But, yeah, you guys kind of get the gist. You know, you try to build up, you know, construct your own strategies and try to get, you know, as many points as you can and then, you know, completing the stages and all that sort. So, hopefully this video helped you guys out. It was kind of hard to explain this, but it's pretty simple, pretty straightforward, right? You want to be really smart with what team you want to bring to, because you, although you don't do damage to the opponents, you can also slow them down. Elemental reaction, very important. So, you know, have fun with this, right? It's a nice, cool thing to have. You know, you can spend a good amount of time in it. So just try to have fun with it and then, you know, see what you can do with your friends or even by yourself, up to you. And all that sort. Anyways, that's going to be it for this video. Hopefully this helped you guys out, you know, explaining the tower defense. Like I said, it's very simple, very easy. Most of us can probably do this very, very easy to do. Anyways, make sure you guys subscribe to the channel. Really would appreciate that. Like the video if you guys enjoyed it. Comment down below if you have any more questions. I'll try to answer them below. Y'all know the drill. Hit the bell notification. Notifies you when I put up a video. And that's going to be it for me. Peace.